Ducks had a day off here in the Twin Cities yesterday, and it was very clear and very cold. It's hockey weather, to say the least, as the Ducks and Wild get together. Hampus Lindholm on a hash mark now feeds it back to the point, and across it's Getzlaf. High tip play is over top of the net as Henrik got a piece of it.
Yeah, good puck movement. Quick puck movement is the key.
In front, Perry all alone. He scores! What a bit of stick handling by Corey Perry, and Anaheim has the game's first goal less than a minute in.
Granlund taps it back towards his own goal crease, and then the scoring touch of Corey Perry. Boy, look at that patience.
Zucker trying to get the puck away from Montour, who gets it to the line, but not out. Long shot by Koivu, who scores! Traffic in front of Gibson from Zucker. This game is tied.
Cam Fowler was stationed in front of the net. Koivu just throws it there. I think it may have hit the skate of Cam Fowler and bounced over the stick and glove hand of John Gibson.
The Wild bring it back, and Anaheim will go for a change. Pettersson and Granlund go after the puck deep in the Anaheim zone. Pettersson lifting Granlund's stick. Now the puck is in his skates to the high slot. It comes through. Prosser shot tipped in. No goal. No goal. Zucker got it with a high stick.
It's close. Here's the shot by Prosser. Here's the stick.
We have a good goal.
Zucker indeed has his 23rd of the year. Waiting at the right point is Bieksa. Dusts it off and slides it across. Lindholm doesn't have anything, so he'll return the favor. Bieksa winds, fires, deflected. Oh, just to the left of Dupik. And Ritchie couldn't find it in time.
Good job of puck recoveries here.
Here's Kasha. Oh, and he's tied the game.
What a play.
Lindholm got it to the front of the net. That's where Kasha was. And the magic continues for the unchecked.
And you know what? Everyone was expecting Kasha to deflect this puck. He didn't. He caught it, and he pulled it back to the backhand and just stuffed it in.
Stahl in the corner along with Henrik, and they battle for it there. Behind the net, Zach Parise. He'll feed the point. Dumba walks it to the middle. Off the post! It's behind Gibson, and he's able to freeze it somehow.
What a break. Matt Dumba does a great job of releasing this shot in a hurry, and it is ticketed. It's off the inside of the post. It bounces right back, and Gibson clicks the heels together, and it sticks right underneath him.
And the faceoff comes to neutral ice, almost ensuring overtime here at XL Energy Center this afternoon. Perry fires wide of the net as the horn sounds, and that's exactly where we are headed. Bonus hockey. Now trying to get back in the play as Fowler defensively, as Stahl drops it off. Granlund's been out there a long time. His shot blocked. Got it back. Blocked by Fowler. Oh, a game saver by Cam.
We've talked about blocking shots. There's the biggest block of the game right there.
So now we head to the shootout. Minnesota shot first, so Granlund, the first shooter of the seventh round, and he's going to come with speed. Swings wide off the left side. Gibson's got it in his equipment somewhere.
And now it's Silverberg.
Save Dubnyk. Charlie Coyle to begin the eighth round of the shootout. Oh, and he stacks the pads, old school. Brandon Montour, and he won't, as Dubnyk way out got the blocker on it. It is the 10th round of the shootout. Oh, and reaching back with the right pad, Gibson. He looked like he had him beat. Antoine Vermette can win it for the Ducks. And he didn't really get a very good shot away. I think he lost the handle as well.
He did.
Matt Dumba. He went for the poke check and made the save with the pad.
Same move by Gibson.
Nick Ritchie in the 11th round. Wins it for the Ducks. He went 5-hole. And Anaheim wins in a shootout this afternoon in Minnesota.
Now, what a huge point. Just an enormous point as Nick Ritchie snaps it low.
Shot number 11 for the Anaheim Ducks. And boy, is this a big additional point. They picked up winning over Minnesota 3-2.